How's it going, guys? My name is TJP, and welcome back to MLB The Show 22 franchise. So, we have our final AL West team and our final AL team in this series that we're doing. So, rebuilding all 30 teams. So, Texas Rangers, that's what we got today. If you guys are excited for this video, leave a like and subscribe, and let me know down in the comments below some more video ideas. Check out my socials down in the description. Got a playlist down below containing other MLB The Show 22 franchise rebuilds. And check out my channel for like content from me, TJP. So, obviously, these are meant to be fun, just like they've been for the past 28, and that'll be the same case for tomorrow's rebuild of the Giants. So, with that being all said, let's get on to the gameplay. Alright, so we are locked and loaded into MLB The Show 22, and as you guys see, there's a ton of red, and a lot of it's got to do with the pitching. We got to work on that, but let's take a look at the lineups here, everybody. So, you got Daniel Lowe, Ezekiel Duran, we've got Corey Seager, who they picked up, same thing with Semien, so... Pretty good stuff here. I mean, Corey Seager usually does well in the simulation, so we'll see how Marcus does as well. We got Brad Miller, Willie Calhoun, Mitch Garver behind the dish with Adolis Garcia, then Cole Calhoun is out there in right. We got Rex, we've got Jon Heim, Andy Ibanez, Charlie Culberson, Nick Solak. I mean, yeah, there's some work to be done here. There's some work to be done with the Rangers, but we will see. We will see. What moves we can get there, but I think our pitching definitely needs to improve. I mean, we've got Dane Dunning, John Gray, Colby Allard, Taylor Hearn, and Martin Perez. Yeah, we definitely want to get some starting pitching here. And just looking at the bullpen, we might need some help there. Got Matt Bush, John King as a closer is okay, but you know, we could probably improve our pitching. That's definitely something we're gonna do before we start simulating. So let's see if we can try to get a better starter, some better relievers. That's the first thing I want to do. All right, first thing I'm going to do with the Diamondbacks, we're going to give up Martin Perez, Matt Carpenter, Zach Rex to the Diamondbacks for Bumgarner, JB Wendelken, and No Ramirez. So basically getting a better starting pitcher and also two pretty solid relievers. So that's basically one trade down the books there for pitching. So I'll take it. All right, I'm going to do this deal with the Twins. So we're going to get Max Kepler for Willie Calhoun, Brad Miller, and Garrett Richards. Just a slight upgrade, I'd say, from Cole Calhoun, so I'm probably just going to end up moving Cole Calhoun for maybe some prospects. I don't even care if they're mid-level, so I'll just see what trades out there for him since I want to clear up a little bit of budget, and then I think we'll just start simulating. Right, I'll do the trade with the White Sox, Blake Rutherford and Jonathan Stiver for Cole Calhoun just to clear up some cap space, so here we go. Thank you very much, or budget, rather. So yeah, I think those are all the moves we're going to make. It's not a huge... We didn't really make too many huge upgrades. I think this team's not going to do that great in this first season. Might look to make some moves at the All-Star break, but I don't expect to make the postseason. I'm more focused on the next two seasons. So I'm going to start simulating. I'll see you guys at the All-Star break. All-Star week is upon us, currently sitting at 43-54. So yeah, looking like we're not going to be making the postseason this year, which is not a problem. I was not expecting that. And, yeah, let's see how the lineup's looking. So, Daniel Lowe's having a pretty good year. I guess Pozo's up here. Okay. Corey Seager, pretty solid. Marcus Semien, okay, it's been kind of chilly. Mitch Garver, decent behind the dish. Garcia's been kind of cold this year. Kepler's been on fire as of late, but hasn't had an amazing season. Solak's been eh. And then we got Josh Jung, who's pretty good for a prospect, but obviously not doing too well right now. Culberson's having a pretty solid year, though. So, they were not really hitting the ball that well. Definitely have to address that in the offseason, but, you know, for now, it's fine. Bumgarner, decent stats other than the record. Dane Dunning's not doing that great. John Gray's been cold, and he's making a lot of money. Colby Allard has been terrible, and then Kohei Arihara has not been great either, especially as of late. The bullpen, for the most part, hasn't been good either. John King's been decent. But other than that, yeah, really nobody's been... And Brett Martin's been okay. Yeah, Noh's been struggling. JB Wendelken hasn't been good either. So, yeah, I don't know. I mean, we can try to make another trade here, but it would basically just be for next season since I don't see us making the postseason this year. Alright, I'll do this deal with the Cubs. We're going to get Ian Happ for Pozo, Patton, Rodriguez. So, Ian Happ's going to be our new starting left fielder. Cool with that. 69-93 with a 426 win percentage, 42.6%. And yeah, that's not good enough to make the postseason, obviously. So we did not have the greatest season, which is fine. I didn't expect us to be that great. Couple injuries. Mitch Garver got hurt, which is a little unfortunate. Okay. But for the most part, yeah, it wasn't really going to make too much of a difference. Just looking at the stats, Lowe was pretty solid. Jung kind of was meh. Seager ended the season on fire. Ian Happ had a good year. Marcus Semien kind of had a... He definitely had a down year from his performance last year where he played all 162 games. 45 homers, 100 RBIs. Yeah, definitely a dip. Kepler, you know, he was... Garcia had a bad year in terms of average. He didn't really hit that well. Jonah behind the plate is our backup. And then Solak. All right. Charlie Culberson, decent, though. How about Cameron Cawley? When he played, 18 at-bats, 10 hits. So he made the most out of his limited opportunity. So fair play to him. But we're probably not going to be seeing too much of him. Okay, yeah, no one else really was that great. Our pitching, Bumgarner was probably our best pitcher. Yeah. Yeah, and the records were not very good from anybody, except for Kohei. His was decent, but even then, the stats weren't that good. Taylor Hearn struggled. Other than Brett Martins, okay, Josh was pretty good. Josh Boers, Wendelken kind of struggled. Barlow struggled, and John King was really good, though. 38 saves. I'll give him that. He was probably our best bullpen pitcher. Probably our best pitcher, actually, in general. So, let's just see when's the World Series, and then get on with the offseason. The Brewers beating the Angels. Cool stuff. So we have a lot of work to do if we want to make the postseason next upcoming season. So let's see if we can get some players on this team. All right, so I'm going to do my offering of the arbitration to offer some arbitration. I feel like we're not going to have too much money just because Corey Seager's making so much money. So I don't know. Maybe we... I don't know what we do about him, but we're probably going to trade Gray at some point. So that'll probably clear up some budget for us. But let me do this arbitration tender the contract so you guys are free agency. A little bit of budget here and trade for Drew Pomeranz from the Padres for John Gray. So that is going to be one of our trades to do there. Save some budget. But yeah, in terms of free agency, we have a decent amount of money. Definitely going to focus on pitching. Might try to get a third baseman, whether it be via trade or something like that. So, but our main focus in free agency is going to be pitching. So let's see if we can sign some guys for this team. All right, so we did pick up Clayton Kershaw to add to our rotation, which is pretty solid. I did try to offer a bunch of other guys. I'm not sure if we ended up getting them because I did reach my max signing. So, okay, we did get Michael Fulmer to add to the bullpen as well as Trevor Rosenthal. So I wanted to also sign Joe Musgrove, but he ended up going to the Dodgers, which is fine. So I think now, I mean, we're slightly improved, but really not that much. I still need a third baseman, so I might look to try to trade one once more guys are starting to sign. So, and I think Madison Bumgarner might be the target that we trade just because he's making a lot of money. I feel like he's going to regress. So I don't know. Let's see if there's a third baseman we can trade out there for. All right, I'll do this trade with the Yankees. Madison Bumgarner, Benny Brown, and Bubba Thompson for DJ LeMahieu and Luis Severino. So we get DJ LeMahieu, who's going to be our third baseman. He can also DH as well occasionally. And we also get Severino to add to the rotation. So I'm cool with that. And I think that's the only trade we're going to make. So I think we might be able to sign somebody else in free agency. We'll offer another contract for another pitcher. But might have run out of space. But if I didn't, I'll see if I can make another signing. And then after that, I think I'm just going to simulate to the start of the second season. All right, so quick update while I'm just simulating to the start of the next season. Do we want to do this trade? Stefan Crichton for Miguel Aparicio. Do I want to do that? No, I don't want to do that. It's fine. Okay, so we did get Zach Eflin to add to the rotation, so that's pretty much all the moves we're making. So I'm just going to finish simulating this, and then we're going to get to the start of the third and final season. So let's just renew that guy's contract at $700,000. It's not a big of a deal. So yeah, let me just get rid of all this crap. Lineup. So we got DJ LeMahieu, Daniel Lowe, So yeah, and Daniel. We got Seager, Hap, Semien, Garver, Kepler, Jung, and Garcia. We got Jonah off the bench, Charlie Culberson, Nick Solak, Kim Colley, who's actually, you know, remember he had that 556 average. So yeah, and then the rest of the bench. Yeah, there's some decent players coming off the bench here. Obviously spring training, so they won't all be here, but our rotation's looking a little bit better this season with Kershaw, Severino, Eflin, and then got Dane Dunning and then Colby Allard. Got Kohei in the bullpen, John King, who's here now, Fulmer, Rosenthal, Drew Pomeranz, Wendell Kinn, Barlow. So, I mean, I think the bullpen's a little bit better. The pitching, I feel like, is improved. I think the hitting's okay. I think we've gotten better. We might be able to slip in as a wild card team. I don't know if we'll win the division, but we're going to simulate and see how this team does. So I will see you guys at the All-Star break. After break, and we're only sitting at 45-51, so kind of underperforming a bit. Yeah, we're going to have to make some trades. So we will do that. Looks like we had some injuries, though, this season. I feel like we've had some injuries, but I don't know. Either way, you know, Daniel's been kind of cold as of late. Mayhew's been meh. Seager's not doing as great as he usually does in the simulation. So I might have to look to move him if he's going to struggle. Ian Happ, okay. What's happening? Marcus also isn't really doing that great. Yeah, the hitting is not really there. Jung has been pretty good, though. He's been on fire as of late, so that's nice to see. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm not a fan of what I'm seeing right now. Culberson's done well as a platoon guy, and so is Tavares. But, yeah, I'm a little concerned. Kershaw's been good. Severino's been good. Eflin's been very nice with the record. Dunning's been struggling, and then Colby's been absolutely putrid. So that's a problem that we need to address because he's been putrid. So, and then just looking at our bullpen, John King's been pretty good. Rosenthal's kind of struggling. Noah's been good. Fulmer's been eh. Barlow's been decent. And then Drew is our closer, 26 saves. So, yeah, we're going to make some trades right now. Got to get some better hitting, and we got to get another starting pitcher because I cannot have Colby pitching if he's going to pitch like that. So, or maybe we call up a pitcher. We could call up, I was going to call up Jack, but yeah, let's call up Jack Leiter. Why not? We're going to call him up instead, and hopefully he will be our starting pitcher. So we'll move him to the MLB. Not on the 40-man roster. Why? Okay. Remove from 40-man roster. Doesn't make any sense. I let the CPUs manage this, and it's like they make the most questionable decisions sometimes, and I'm just like, okay. All right, moving to MLB. There we go. And then Colby, do I want to move him down? I think we move him down to AAA. So we're going to do that. Colby's going to AAA. Jackson be in the MLB. So let's see if we can make some trades, though. Let's see if we can get another bat in this lineup. I did this share with the Cubs. Chavez, who we drafted, who's got a lot of potential. Kepler and Justin Foscue. For Bellinger, Suzuki, and Caleb Killian from the Cubs. So, I mean, we're getting two quality starting players. So, I'm going to do this deal, especially since Garcia's not doing that great. And Kepler isn't expiring. And he, you know, is not doing, like, lighting up the world. So, we're going to do this trade with them. So, thank you, Cubs. Maybe that'll salvage the season, but we'll see. So, we were able to salvage the season somewhat, going 87-75. Didn't make the postseason. We made it, but only as a wildcard team. So, we could potentially, our season could end in one game. We went 87-75. And the Angels got eliminated. The Astros were 89-73. So, look at that. We got two games up on them. You guys see the rest of the standings. The Braves had 105 wins, so they were the best team in the league. So, in terms of league leaders, you guys can see Zach was really good. Awards. Drew Pomeranz was the delivery man of the year. Good for him. And Trout was MVP. Good for him. But who cares? You didn't make the postseason, my guy. Injuries, nobody right now, which is cool. In terms of our lineups, Marcus, I don't know what's going on with Marcus, man. He is regressed like crazy. Him and Seager have not been doing that great in the simulation, which has been a little annoying. LeMahieu was, you know, kind of down from last year, but, you know, I guess it was okay. Ian happened a nice year, though. We extended him. Nathaniel was okay. Suzuki, Bellinger ended the season kind of cold. Jung, pretty solid. And Garver's a catcher. I mean, honestly, nobody lit the world on fire, but I guess no one was, like, putrid in the starting lineup, so, I mean, it's fine. Culberson off the bench has been pretty good, so that's cool to see from him. I feel like our pitching was really good, especially our starters. Kershaw, 11-10, not amazing, but we'll take it. Severino ended the season on fire, which is pretty good. Zach was awesome. Dane Dunning ended the season on fire, but it wasn't amazing. And then Jack Leiter, though, we'll take that from him. So good stuff, Jack. And then Colby was terrible. I don't know why he's in the pros. Then Caleb Killian wasn't that great either. Fulmer wasn't great. Noah was good, though. King was all right. Rosenthal kind of struggled. And then Drew obviously won delivery in the year. 54 saves. We will take that. We will take that from him. So, we got one game to beat the Astros. Can we do it? No, we can't. We lose 3-2. Oh! So, we made the postseason. And look at that! In typical MLB The Show 22 fashion, had a lead and blew it. Had a lead and blew it. 2-0 lead, and we blew it. Fantastic. Love to see it. Kershaw got the L. Doing his thing out there in the postseason. All right. Well, we got one more year. Who's going to win the World Series? It's going to be the Dodgers beating the Mariners. So we got one more season. Let's see if we can get us a World Series in this upcoming year. So I offered a few guys some exclusive free agents. Culberson declined his option. We offered him, though. I reached out to Drew, and obviously no. So there you go. We're not going to have a lot of money. So that's going to be kind of scary in terms of what we want to do here. So we might be able to add a couple guys. But that's really about it. We might have to do some trades. We'll see. We'll see how we do. We're just going to do the tendering of the contracts. And I'll see you guys at free agency. All right, so at free agency, we're not going to have a lot of money. But I'm going to try to see if we can add a few guys to this team. Definitely want to improve the bullpen, I think. We'll try to make some trades as well. But that's pretty much all we can do. We don't have a lot of money, so. Yankees. So we're going to trade DJ LeMahieu back to the Yankees. Jimmy and Arihara for Gerrit Cole and Tommy Canley. So we're going to improve the starting rotation again. And we're going to get Tommy Canley. Now we have not a lot of budget whatsoever. So all these guys that I offered contracts to, we're not going to be able to get them, probably. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe we'll get a couple of them. But, yeah, we're gonna have to get a third baseman now. But let's just simulate the rest of free agency and see what happens. The Royals want to give me Bobby Witt Jr., Nick Prado for Sam Huff, Eli White, and Adelis Garcia. Sure. I'll do that with the Royals. Thank you. With the Nationals, Dustin Harris, Joseph Pena, and Cole Wynn for Brady House. Again, maybe we could use that in a potential deal in our third and final season, so I'm cool with that. Or if Corey Seager just, I don't know, is wanting to suck this video, then that's fine too. So we got a couple guys. Culberson, if we can get him back, no, as well, we can get them back to be cool. But yeah, I think we might be kind of budget restricted, so yeah, let's just simulate the rest of free agency. I'll see you guys at the start of third and final season. All right, third and final season. I honestly think this team could be pretty good. Taking a look at the lineup, we got Marc Semien, we got Lau, we got Seager, Hap, Suzuki, Bellinger, Jung, Garver, and Brady House. So I guess Seager's gonna be the DH constantly. I'm cool with that. All right, obviously, got Bobby Witt, we got Nick Prado up here, we got Jonah, we got Culberson back, which is pretty cool. Tavares, Garcia, Cameron Colley, who didn't play last year, Duran. All right, it's a pretty solid team. I'm liking it. Kershaw, Cole, Severino, Eflin, and Dunning. Pretty decent. We got Jack Leiter. I did get Danny Duffy. We got Colby, Stanek we signed, which is pretty cool. Killian, got Canley in the deal as well. We got Tapera, Barlow, King, we still got Brett Martin, Fulmer, Rosenthal, Wendelken, no Ramirez we got back as well. So it's not bad. I think this team is overall pretty solid. I think we could potentially win the division this year. The question is, will we need to make a move at the deadline or at the All-Star break? Well, that's really needs to be seen, or maybe even before then. But I'm liking this team. I think we could be pretty good. We'll have to figure out how the third base situation is going to work out. But I think Jung's been pretty good. Josh Jung's been pretty good. So we'll see if he can continue to play well. All-Star week is upon us, and we are sitting at 62-34, which is the best in the West. And actually, it's the best in the AL. The Dodgers have 63 wins, so we're only a game behind them for the best record in the whole entire league. And we've had some injuries. Josh has been hurt, and he wasn't that great when he got hurt, so that's annoying. Nick Pro's not even in the pros, but he was doing well. Okay, it's unfortunate. Let's just take a look at the lineup. So that means Bobby Witt's playing third. Let's see how the team's doing. So Daniel's been awesome this year. Brady House is wow, he's having a really good season. All right. Corey Seager, when he's not having the field, is doing a little bit better. Ian Happ is having a good year. Bellinger's been cold, but he's been doing good for the season. Suzuki's been on fire as of late. Man, Marcus Semien, what's going on, brother? Struggling. Mitch Garver, though, good stuff from him. And then Bobby Witt, you know, hasn't played that much, but it looks like maybe he can do pretty good. So we'll see. And Culberson's been obviously pretty solid as well. So picking up the slack there. I'm actually happy with this team for the most part, other than Marcus Semien, who's been really bad. I'm a little disappointed in him. He's been disappointing, to say the least. So what are you gonna do? In terms of our pitching, Garrett Cole's been awesome, so that's great to see. Severino's been cold as of late, but he's had a pretty solid year. Kershaw's been awesome. Zach Eflin, not too bad as well, 9-1, so he's getting a lot of that run support, which is cool. Jack Leiter has been pretty awesome himself. Dunning in the bullpen's not been that great. Duffy's been kind of struggling a little bit. Fulmer's been good. Tapera's struggling. John King, decent. Ryan Stanek has been awesome. Barlow's been great. And Tommy Canley's been garbage. So there is that. Is it worth making a trade? Maybe. It might be worth making a trade. It would be worth making a trade if I could do one for Nick Prado, since he's not in the pros. Josh Jung. But I think we might just rock with this team. I don't see why we wouldn't rock with the squad. Unless there's like anybody here that's got some value, which there might be, but I think we're just going to keep the team the way it is and see you guys at the end of the season. We ended up going 90-64, won our division, and taking the win of the wildcard playoff game. Not an amazing record in terms of 90-64. I mean, it's great, don't get me wrong, but not 100 wins. And I guess really nobody had 100 wins. I mean, the Braves did, and the Dodgers did. So really no one was like incredibly great. So, good stuff from us, though. I'll take it. I can't be mad. Obviously, Zach Eflin, I guess whenever he pitches, the team's just like, yeah, let's be really good at the game. Ian Happ, also. What a nice season from Ian Happ. He was a great pickup for us in this video. And, wait, did we have another league leader? We did. Daniel, also 292 average. That's good to see from him. We have any awards? Cy Young, Garrett Cole. Okay, Garrett. I see you. He had a good year. Very good year for him. Any injuries? Severino, torn rotator cuff. That's unfortunate. That is very unfortunate. So he will not be playing in the postseason. That's a bit of an L. Suzuki, though, ended the season on fire. Nice to see. Brady House, pretty solid year. Same thing with Corey Seager, although they're both cold. Bellinger, nice year from him. Nakano was great. Obviously, Ian Happ was really awesome. Yeah, Marcus, kind of a disappointment. Jung, decent. And then Garver will take it. Bobby Witt wasn't that great. Just the rest of the team, not too bad. I mean, it's the bench, you know, when they get their reps. So pitcher rotation, Garrett Cole obviously won the Cy Young, so he was awesome. Kershaw was okay. Jack Leiter, decent. Zach Eflin obviously had the best winning percentage. That's good to see from him. Dane Dunning, you know, could be a little bit better. Duffy struggled this year. Fulmer was good. Ryan Tepera is pretty solid. You know, No didn't pitch, but I guess he'll add to the bullpen. Killian didn't pitch that much either in the pros, because I'm assuming he was mostly in the minors. So that's probably why. Stanek was awesome in the bullpen. Barlow was meh. And then Tommy Canley was just really bad. So hopefully he doesn't pitch that much. I mean, 43 saves is nice, but yeah, just too, you know, too many blown saves. So hopefully we don't see too much of him. So we're down the winner between Tampa Bay and Seattle. It is probably going to end up being one of those two teams. Obviously, it's going to be one of those two teams. There's another team it could be. It's going to be Tampa Bay. All right, Culver's Cy Young winner. Game one, we win 5-4. Kershaw on the bump for game two. We win 6-4. Can we sweep them? We do. Nice. Taking on the Jays, the Blue Jays, in the ALCS, which, if I remember correctly, this is a rematch of the... No, not really. It is not a rematch of the ALCS. It's a rematch of the... would be the ALDS. I don't know. It doesn't even matter. It's really not a rematch. Okay, game one, Cole versus Manoa. We lose 3-2. I deserve the L after speaking so much garbage, but we win game two. Can we win game three? We win game three. Lose game four. Lose game five. Win game six. Can we win game seven? You guys know. It's game seven, and of course we lose. So that is unfortunate, as a lot didn't that great on the mound that day. So that's cool. Did we have an injury, or is it just me? Maybe we didn't have an injury. I don't know what happened. I guess... Yeah, I don't know what happened. I thought maybe Cole got hurt, but I don't think he got hurt. I just don't think that he got the win. Yeah, he just didn't get the win. Okay. Well, we got to Game 7 of an ALCS. Could not win the World Series, so it's going to be between Toronto and Atlanta. Who's going to be the Blue Jays? So we lost to the eventual World Series champs. What are you going to do? That's our final AL team. Let's go to the full screen close of the video. All right, that's going to be it for me. If you guys enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe, and let me know down in the comments below some more videos. Check my social down in the description. I'll play this down below, containing other MLB The Show 22 franchises we've been in contact. Check my channel if you like content from me, TJP. We've got one more team, and it's going to be the San Francisco Giants NL West team. And then after that, we got our fun rebuilds, some fun rebuilds to do. So we'll mix those in. Might do some Road to the Show as well. Obviously, we'll keep up with the Mario Super Sluggers Alphabet Challenge. And maybe we'll mix in a few other videos in. I don't know, maybe some quizzes or random games, because I feel like it's just been baseball the entire time. So maybe we have to switch it up a little bit. Oh, and then obviously maybe like that one video where I said, how much money do I make? Because sure, why not? Content. Anyways, I'm done speaking. I'll see you guys soon. Take care. Peace.